Next up, here on the Startup Health TV, we've got Miguel Johns.
Yep.
Miguel, thanks very much for joining me.
Thank you.
You have a mic there? Now, Miguel, you're the founder and CEO of DiabetesCare.
Yes.
Tell me about, first of all, tell me about your moonshot. What are you trying to do with diabetes? It's a huge problem everywhere. Tell me what you're trying to do.
So our moonshot is to provide high-quality diabetes education to people worldwide.
Okay, that's a great cause. I personally have been affected by diabetes in my family, so it's something I know fairly well. My personal knowledge has gone up quite a lot. How are you actually going about doing that?
Yeah, so we have created a video-based diabetes education program that's powered by machine learning and delivered using social media.
Okay, tell me more about that. So is it, first of all, is it for type 1, type 2, or all sorts of diabetes?
Mm-hmm, all sorts of diabetes.
Okay.
Our education is video-based, and so we're seeing a lot of diabetes programs, management programs, new devices, new technologies arising in the market, but there's still a significant problem when it comes to people being educated about what they can actually do about their personal situation. And so our goal is to create entertaining enough content that fits in today's modern communication world with bite-sized videos and social media so that people are willing to actually spend their free time learning about diabetes.
Well, that's great. So what is the business model behind it? Who's actually paying for the service and how do they actually access it?
Yeah, so we've got two tiers to our business model. The first tier, and what we're hoping to accomplish while we're here at Startup Health and in 2020, is based on sponsorships. So right now we're reaching nearly 1 million views every month on our content. So we're looking for partners in the device space and the medication space who have an interest in our audience, which are people with type 2 diabetes, mostly a few people with type 1. Now, as we work through this process and understand how our technology can improve the lives of these individuals, we are measuring health outcomes. So the second tier to our business model is to pursue health plans as customers.
Excellent. So Miguel, tell me why this is important to you. Why did you decide to become a founder of this company?
Yeah. So my dad has diabetes, grandmother has diabetes, aunts and uncles all have diabetes. When my grandmother was diagnosed, she actually wanted to start living healthier, so she stopped drinking pop, but she told me she was going to be starting to drink fruit juice and chocolate milk. And so, unfortunately, we know those have just as much sugar as pop does.
Right.
And that opened my eyes to realize how uneducated people are around the topic and what's actually good for their health long term.
Now, you're focused here in the U.S. market initially?
So we started in the U.S. We are promoting a lot of both English and Spanish content in the United States. And as we started doing that, we had a rush of users come from across the border in Mexico.
Oh, okay.
And so now we've got 20,000 users in Mexico, and that's almost where about 950,000 of our monthly views are all coming from Mexico currently, where diabetes is just as big a problem as in the U.S.
Excellent. So how do people find out about this service and access it? People who are listening who might be interested in using it themselves or sharing it with people they know.
Yeah, so you can search our Facebook page, which is where our first touch point happens. We've got a Facebook page called Diabetes Care in both English and Spanish. We're putting out 2 bite-sized videos every single week on a wide range of different topics, whether it's medication, getting physically active, eating better. Those are going out on Facebook. They're reaching people with diabetes or an interest in diabetes. From there, we're engaging those users using Facebook Messenger and WhatsApp, starting conversations, gathering information, and then sending them down an individualized path that we hope will lead to better health outcomes. That begins with education, and in 2020, as we establish more partners, we'll eventually start feeding those users into different, more intensive programs based on that individual's needs.
Excellent. Make sure you hold that microphone in front
yes.
so that everyone
oh, sorry.
At home can hear you. So in 2019, Miguel, you changed the name from
yes.
KingFit to Diabetes Care. Why the change?
Yes, just so it was a lot more focused on the end user. We wanted to get out of the world of just focusing on employers and health plans and large organizations and get down to the consumer where the action actually happens. We need the end user to take action before any of these programs can work. And so we wanted to make our name recognizable for what we were doing. And now, although KingFit is still the name of the organization, Diabetes Care is the name of the newest product that we rolled out in 2019.
Excellent. So we're here at the beginning of a new year, beginning of a new decade.
Yes.
What are some of the things we can expect to see from you over the next 12 months?
Yes, so to start this year, we're very, very excited because we're reaching 1 million views every month on our content, which was the biggest feat we needed to tackle to make sure that this product would actually work. Can we get people to engage outside of their regular entertainment hours? So that being accomplished as of today, our next step is to align ourselves with the right strategic partners who have a high interest in our audience so that we can work with them and continue to improve the lives of our users and our viewers by giving them the products and resources that they need to continue to take those next steps.
That's brilliant. Well, I wish you a lot of luck as you work to do that. It's a very important problem that you're working to address. I'm sure that this is something that you're building something that you wish your mother and father had had access to some time ago, right?
Yes, definitely.
Excellent. Well, good luck in doing that. And people can find out more about diabetes care by going to startuphealth.com and searching for diabetes care. And they can also go to diabetescare.com.
.io.
.io.
Yes.
Diabetescare.io. All right, Miguel, thanks so much.
Thank you.